Hello everyone, my name is Tianline and today I show you how you can obtain the coin of Illusory Witch's Memento in the Elder Scrolls Online. To be able to get this memento, you need to have access to the Thief's Guild DLC. You have to complete the achievement A Cut Purse Above to be rewarded with the coin of Illusory Witch's Memento and the Master Thief title. To complete this achievement, you have to steal 16 legendary treasures from Kari's hitlist and bring them back to the Thief's Den in Abba's Landing. Travel to Spain, and in the center of the Thief's Den, you can find a book with Kari's hitlist, which will provide some clues where you have to look for the items. Be careful not to get caught by guards, since if you turn over your stolen goods, these items will be taken from your inventory and placed back at the original locations. We will start our Thief's Tour in Glenumbra in the city Daggerfall. Go to the western part of the city and enter the Daggerfall Castle. Raven, the Rennie's inflammable rug, is located inside a storage chest in the southern part of the castle. Now we go to Stormhaven. In Waywest you have to visit the Mage's Guild. When you enter the Mage's Guild Hall, you will find on the left hand side on the table King Faringal's unpublished ode to Waywest. Next you have to travel to the city Shornham in Rivenspire. Go to the Fighter's Guild, which is located in the southeastern part of Shornham. Once you are inside the Fighter's Guild, you have to turn to the right and enter the next room on the right. Search the antique chest to obtain Princess Rael's half-hearted love letters. Next object is in Bankorei. You have to visit the Anchor's Point Inn in Evermore. Go upstairs and enter the bedroom on the right side. There you will find on the chest of drawers the Yokeda Sesnitz paper whites. Now you have to travel to Aliki Desert. Visit in the city Sentinel, the Sisters of the Sands Inn. Immediately when you enter the inn, you will see the Divot's hunting triple bowl atop the reception desk. The next destination is Auridon. In the eastern part of Skywatch, you have to go to the Skywatch Manor. Next to the throne room, on a dresser, you will find the coronation decanter of Prince Naemon. Then you have to travel to Gradwood. Enter the Altmore Embassy, which is located in the southern part of Eldenwood. You will find the burial mannequin of Calathor Cameron inside of an unsealed urn in the southwestern part of the embassy. Next item is located in Greenshade. You have to go to the city Marbrook and visit the Mage's Guild. On a table at the upper floor, you will find three Thanes Nereal's Living's Plantware book set. Now you have to visit Vaelin Harbor in Malabal Tor. In the Mage's Guild you have to steal the Tuner's Harp of Figarion the Bard. When you enter the Mage's Guild, go straight across the room and you will find the harp sitting on a desk. Then we have to go to Reaper's March. Go to the Mage's Guild in Wolkar and you will find on a table the Herbal Spittoon of Derlock Bray. Next destination is Craggenmoor in Stonefalls. In the basement of the Isengard Inn, you have to steal the Akaviri Armistice Banquet Tray. Now you have to go to the city center in Mournhold in Deshan. Enter the city center and the ground floor, walk past the different furnishing vendors and follow the hallway. In the left corner of the bank room, you have to search the preservation chest to find King Dumek's Roll Latrine Cloth Roll. Then you have to travel to Shadowfen. In the center of Stormhold is a small history. Next to the tree, you can collect Chairman Shira's Devotion Shovel. The next location is Windhelm in Eastmarch. Not far away from the Windhelm Way Shrine, you will find the Mage's Guild. On the right hand side of the guild hall, you will see King Jorun's automatic cheese wheel vivisector. Now we have to travel to the Rift. In Riften, you have to go to the Fighter's Guild. Upstairs on the dresser, you can pick up Iskramor's Sloatskin wine sack. The last destination of our stealing tour is Abba's Landing in New Spain. You have to go to the bank of Abba's Landing. When you enter the bank, you will find on the left hand side Prince Hubalat's trash urn. After you collected all 16 items, you have to return to the Thief's Den in New Spain. Go to the center of the thief's den and place each treasure from Kari's hit list on the golden glowing locations. When you place the last item, you will complete the Cut Purse Above achievement, and the coin of Illusory Riches will be added to your memento collection. Also, you will earn the Master Thief title. I am not sure if this memento is in general a bit buggy or it does just not work correct for me. As far as I know, you should get a rain of coins, and the coins should land on the ground and stay visible for some time. For me, the coins on the ground were never visible, and I only see the coins falling down if I look on my character with the camera completely zoomed out. In case you have problems with the memento animation tool, please send in-game a bug report. Hopefully, you enjoyed my guide how you can acquire the Coin of Illusory Riches memento in the Elder Scrolls Online. It would be wonderful if you subscribe, like, or leave me a comment. Have a nice day and until next time, tschüss!